No cheering. Pet nups. And QR codes at the cemetery? I'm Paul Andecker. That's what I'm buzzing about today, this Wednesday, June 23rd. The Daily Buzz is next. Paul Andecker in the Thursday edition of The Daily Buzz. Just keep that coffee coming. Another study is praising the human obsession with Java. Latest research suggests the brew could be linked to a lower chance of developing or dying from chronic liver disease, a major health problem around the world. So it doesn't matter how you have it, espresso, instant, bought or made at home, coffee goes a long way. Well, you've heard about adopting a highway to keep it clean. Well, in South Carolina, they're doing an Adopt-a-Drain program to keep areas clean from trash and debris and avoid flooding. City says dozens of storm drains are available for adoption. AAA says more than 47 million Americans plan to celebrate the 4th by hitting the road. They're expecting 40% more holiday travel compared to last year. Not only is that the most since the start of the pandemic, it could end up being the second most traveled Independence Day weekend ever. And even though gas prices are the highest they've been in 7 years, 91% of Americans say they'll do their holiday traveling by car. Happy motoring. Looks like you're not the only one who can't spell quarantine. AT&T reviewed which words people Googled for correct spelling, and quarantine was the most searched. It was usually spelled corn-teen, like corn on the cob, and teen, like 13. Americans also had trouble spelling favorite, coronavirus, and every, like every one of us needs to pick up a dictionary. We'll turn the page in a minute. The Daily Buzz. Daily Buzz Part 2. Now there's a legit health reason to get out of a miserable relationship. New study says unhappy marriages can kill you. Researchers in Israel found that miserable marriages increase the male death rate by 19% and boost a guy's risk of stroke by almost 70%. The University of Tel Aviv traced 32 years of health data and compared bad marriages to smoking or not exercising. Apparently, the study didn't look at the effects on women. I'm sure there are similar effects on them. Here's another bank oops in Florida. Lady went to the ATM to get 20 bucks out. Flipped out when she saw her balance. Somebody at Chase Bank accidentally deposited $1 billion into her account. She's not touching the money. She's just waiting for Chase Bank to fix it. Smart lady. Sometimes breaking a Guinness World Record isn't all that impressive. Like the guy in England who stacked 5 M&Ms on top of each other. That's it. That's all he did to get his name in the record books. 23-year-old says he was bored, looking for something to do during the lockdown. He says he knew he had a shot when he looked it up and found the most anyone had ever stacked was 4. Funny, what does the word staycation really mean? If you thought it meant staying at home, napping on the couch, think again. A third of people say you don't have to stay at home on a staycation. 21% of us think it's when you stay somewhere else in your city or town, like a hotel or Airbnb. Another 10% said you can even leave town. As long as you're not that far from home, it still counts. Overall, more than half of Americans say they've done a staycation before. Knucklehead news out of New York. Stacy Goldstein, principal of the School of the Future in the city's Gramercy Park neighborhood, sent an email to parents last week letting them know there would be no in-person or remote classes for this week, but the students still needed to sign in electronically each day to satisfy attendance requirements. Parents weren't happy, given no explanation about why the decision was made. So one parent complained. If there was ever a year for more instruction rather than less, this was it. There was a lot of frustration over this. They're having kids sign for classes that aren't happening to cover themselves. So the Department of Education said, no, no, no. Instructed the principal to contact the parents, let them all know that students would be required to attend this week. The Daily Buzz. Paul at MidwestFamilySWMI.com. My email if you find something buzzable. Don't forget our podcasts on this station's website. Yesterday's history, tomorrow a mystery. Today it's a gift. That's why it's called the present. I'm Paul Andecker. Let's buzz again tomorrow. Make it a great day.